Hello everyone, welcome to Gold Nugget, J-A-W underscore success. Today I am out and about again on the street, but I want to welcome you to this channel. If it's your first time to the channel, if you are already a subscriber, let me welcome you, because without you, this channel doesn't have the impact that it is supposed to have. And at the end of the day, as I say, this is our growth part, and I welcome you to this growth part. Now, I want to look at a familiar topic, and that topic is no. Many of us do not like to hear no. In fact, some of us don't even know how to say no. I think I am one of those person who fall in that category where I like to say yes, because if I don't say yes, I feel like I will not be loved, I will not be appreciated, I will not be wanted. So sometimes I say yes to my own detriment. However, hearing no is important, but how do we handle no when we hear it? Do we fall into despair? Do we kill the person who tell us no? Or do we still force our hand and get what we want? Now, hearing a no has its value. It has its place. But how do we treat it? Let me put it this way. In life, we're going to hear more no's than we hear yeses. The suggestions that we put forward will not always be accepted. We're going to send out resumes, we're going to send out applications, and those applications are going to end up in file 13. They're going to end up in a stack where we don't want our own to go. We're going to face rejection and be cast aside. How do we handle those? I personally feel that even when we have those kind of situations, we should accept it with a level of grace, because to hear yes sometimes is not our best value. One of my all-time favorite movie is a movie where one of the character was given the opportunity to play a god. And for those who don't know which movie I'm talking, it's one of my favorite movie. It gets me a laugh, with Jim Carrey, Bruce Almighty. In that movie, Bruce, in his just gotten power, said yes to every prayer that was answered, was prayed. And as a result of that, chaos ensued. Why? Because when we get exactly what we want at all times, sometimes we don't know how to use it. But having a no said to us gives us a perspective where we can reevaluate ourselves. We can ask ourselves, was this the best idea? Is this the best that I can come up with? Sometimes hearing a no forces us to grow beyond our limitation. It forces us to reevaluate ourselves, look at what we are doing and say, I can do better. But whenever we hear yes to some things, it puts a cap on us. It causes us to be like a turtle in a shell, because we do not grow beyond that capacity. We limit ourselves. We push ourselves into a corner where we think that this is the end all and be all, and we stop growing. But when we hear no, sometimes it forces us to look at ourselves and say, you know, I can do better than this, right? So hearing a no sometimes rescue us from anonymity. It rescues us from a place of complacency. It rescues us from a place of doldrums. It rescues us from a low place, because hearing a no sometimes forces us to go better and to do better. However, when we hear a no, a lot of us tend to fall into a state of chaos. We feel like the world is falling apart. I read about this guy named John Kennedy Toley, or something to that effect. He was trying to publish a book, and the whole of his time trying to publish a book, he kept on hearing so many no's that he took his own life. But his mother forced herself. She went all out and she got the book to be published. The long and short of it is that the book gave him a posthumous award. He won Pulitzer Publishers Award because of persistence, not on his part, but on the part of his mother. Yes, sometimes hearing a no says to us that we need to force what we have and push forward with it. But it's not all the time we hear a no is going to work out to be the best for us. And as I said in one of the videos before, when we hear no, right, something must kick in, and that is our will. All right, there are some I wills or must will that I think must come into place when we hear a no. The first must will, or the first will that I think must come into place, is a will to evaluate ourselves and ask ourselves the question, is this the best that I can do? Am I pitching my idea to the right people? Is this the right time for my idea? If it's not the right time, the right people, or even the right place, then we must say to ourselves, can I step back? So we must have a will to step back and to look at what we are doing and ask ourselves the question, is this it? Another will that we must is to, we must will ourselves, or we must have a willingness to step back. And in stepping back, I say sometimes we must step down in order to step up. So sometimes we have to step away from the people, we have to step away from the crowd, we have to step away from this idea in order to have the best idea. In other words, we have to take a cut in salary, we have to leave the company and go work for a lesser company that has a greater potential for success. There are some individuals that I've read about. They were with a giant company and it wasn't happening for them. But as soon as they stepped down from where they were and go start working for a little startup company, it blossomed in such a way where they make super profits and they become great, and they are known for it. So sometimes we have to step back in order to step forward. Our next will that we have to do, sometimes we must be willing, okay, to compromise. And sometimes compromise get our foot in the door, all right? It's better to have a glass half full where we can have little more work to do than to have a total empty glass. So when we have our foot in the door, we can say, hey, guess what? I can work this. I can make it better. I can reach to another level. So we must be willing to compromise. And sometimes through compromise, we end up with a win-win, because the other person who is telling us no, give in to certain demands. The problem with a lot of us is that we don't want to compromise, because for us, it's all or nothing. If we can't win everything, we're not winning everything. And so we give up and we lack. I have a friend who, I won't say his name or whatever, he had something that he wanted to do, right? And he was pressing forward with it. But then guess what? There was a time when he had to hear no. And when he took the answer as a no, guess what happened? He is now doing something that he loves to do. And would tell you, Brother Junior, I am glad that I made this decision. Listen, sometimes hearing no, we must or we will have to accept no as a no. You know why? Because that's how rape happened. We hear no, and because we don't accept it as a no, we force ourselves and we get what we want, but it's to our detriment. Sometimes when we hear no, it's for our good. Okay, it's for our growth, it's for our development. And as I said before, it's a evaluation. So we must come down sometimes and say to ourselves, you know that if I press ahead with this thing, it's going to cost me my life, it's going to cost me my career, it's going to cost me my dream, it's going to cost me. A no is a no. So we must be able to look at ourselves and ask ourselves the question, am I dying over something that I should not die over? Am I giving up my dream for something that I should not give up my dream for? We must know the difference between a yes and a no, or when a no means a yes. Because sometimes a no means press forward, okay? It's like as I said before, it's like seeking the girl that you love and you want. Sometimes she's going to tell you no, and you're going to have to press forward because she is a test. She wants to see if you love her enough to come after her. But there are times it's a waste of time chasing after a dream that is never going to work. So how do you handle no will depend on whether or not it's the right time, it's the right idea, it's the right place, it's the right individuals that you're pitching it to, or even the right location. Sometimes we will hear no in a particular place, but we won't hear it in another place. We're just going to have to press forward. As I said before, we will not always hear yes. In fact, we're going to hear more no's than we hear yes. But until we are able to determine when a yes is a yes and a no is a no, and not a yes, then we're always going to be in trouble. So I'm saying to you, no is not always bad. But then again, if we don't know when it is good, then we're going to end up bad. This is J.A.W. saying, thank you. Let's not rape somebody because we don't know the difference. Let's push forward with our dream when a no says to us that you can't go any further than this. This is your cap. All right? God bless you. Bye.